having a highway cut through the middle of a city conflicts with like what a city is trying to accomplish. It's like a group of thousands and thousands of people being brought together. It just really like cuts the city in half instead of bringing it together. I am basically in charge of the Rethink 35 sect on the St. Edward's campus. We've set up booths and rallies in the past to try and get the word out, get signatures, sign postcards. I feel like the most important thing right now is educating people, because I feel like so many people don't know that this is even happening.
When I started to learn more about the discussions around the future of I-35, I started reading more and more about, you know, what other cities have done. And I just knew that morally I could not stand on the sidelines. I had to get involved. This project is going to profoundly impact children who live, play, go to school near I-35. You know, we know from hundreds of studies that children who live within half a mile of highways disproportionately suffer asthma and other serious health impacts.
So specifically with children, you know, with inhaling carbon dioxide, it can cause increased risk of, you know, asthma exacerbations. It can cause worsening allergies. If you have to look at the bottom line of how much is this going to cost, not just looking at it from an economic perspective, saying, okay, if we expand this highway and more Austinites are put at risk by having increased risk of, you know, asthma exacerbations or COPD exacerbations, difficulty breathing, asthma, allergies, different sorts of things. How can we mitigate some of these risks while we're trying to do this project? How do we keep people safe?
So what makes Escuelita del Alma special, in my opinion, is one, we offer one of the first, if not the first, Spanish immersion programs created in Austin for preschool age children. I feel that the highway is very impactful to our school. One, just because it's literally our neighbor. Like, we share a lot of space with the highway. So there's a lot of noise that we contend with. And then, you know, you just have the same sort of respiratory concerns that anybody living next to a major thoroughfare would have. So it really very much feels like it's an entity that we're living next to. It's ever present. It's always there. The impact that the highway expansion or the expansion of I-35 is going to have on our community is going to change our school completely. One, it's going to force us to relocate for a second time. The area that they're expanding into is completely going to force them to demolish all of the space that we occupy, all of the lots that we occupy. So that's one way. It's just going to force us to move. It's going to definitely force us to find another location that is as central as we currently are. It's gonna force us to really look for a location that's as affordable. We would love to be able to keep our community whole.
My name is Veronica Castro de Barrera, and I am a mother, an architect here that has lived in Austin for 25 years. So I have two children that I raised while living right in the shadows of I-35 for 10 years. Raising our family in this context really manifested in my son's constant cough that he had growing up from infancy till he was 4 years of age. And every night he would have a coughing attack. And so we were trying to pinpoint what was the cause of that coughing. He was 4 years old when we moved further away from the highway. We moved to Mueller 14 years ago. It was amazing to notice that all of the coughing subsided. All of the coughing stopped almost overnight. Within a week, he wasn't waking up at night anymore. It was an eye-opening awareness of how another mile east of I-35 could help? And how would that have impacted the life expectancy or the health outcomes of my children?
The Rethink 35 campaign and the I-35 conversation has been transformed by young people. Until recently, young people were not a feature of this conversation. They had just been ignored and left out. And a lot of volunteers with Rethink 35 and other groups have really worked very hard to really center young people, because this infrastructure is for them. Whatever happens, they're going to be the ones that live with it for the rest of their lives. It's much more theirs than the people who are making the decisions, who won't be around when these children are their age. We haven't met one young person who supports expanding I-35. We've met many, many, many young people who are vehemently against expanding this highway.
I would like to tell decision makers that maybe we should listen more to the public and the voices of the people.
I'd like to see like more public transportation, because I think that would it'd be a solution that benefits most people regardless of like socioeconomic status. And I think it's like, it also kind of builds a sense of community.
I would like to say, think about your people. Think about what they want and not just what you want.
We don't want an expansion. We don't want another Katy Freeway here. We don't want all of the emissions and all the noise pollutions to taint what a great city Austin is.